Up next, the AM Kevin Show with your host, Kevin Shorey. But first, we would like to tell you a little bit about Kevin Shorey Ministries. 38 years ago, Kevin Shorey felt the calling to use his talents as a singer, songwriter, and evangelist to help fulfill the Great Commission to go into all the world and preach the gospel. Today, Kevin Shorey Ministries is continuing this mission through television, radio, social media, streaming, music, and evangelistic services. During the show, Kevin will tell you how you can help him spread the word that Jesus is the answer for this world today. Won't you consider helping us in this great cause? Thank you. Now, sit back and enjoy this edition of AM Kevin. The following program is presented by Kevin Shorey Ministries, whose mission is to fulfill the Great Commission by spreading the word that Jesus is the answer for this world today. What time is it? Why, it's time for AM Kevin. That's right. From Music City, USA, Nashville, Tennessee, it's time once again for another edition of AM Kevin. Starring evangelist, composer, and gospel artist Kevin Shorey and the entire AM Kevin Club gang. And now, from the AM Kevin studios located in Stonebridge Books and Gifts in beautiful Ashland City, Tennessee, reaching coast to coast and around the world with the message that Jesus is the answer for this world today, is your host, Kevin Shorey.
Good morning and welcome to the AM Kevin Club. I apologize for starting late. I didn't realize the time. Just received some devastating news, so I did not know about the time. But a dear lady in our church was killed in a car accident yesterday and just saw the news today. And so we're already freezing, but well, no worries. We're going forward, and it's recording. And like you can get yesterday's program, you can watch it if you miss some of the song or any of that stuff. And speaking of song, I think I'll sing a song to encourage myself. I'm going to sing a song. Although we have, ladies and gentlemen, today live, that's why the big cheering. Let's see if I can get the cheering back on again. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. It's Ma Bell! Yay! Hi, Ma Bell. Welcome to the AM Kevin Club. Welcome back.
Thanks for having me.
All the way back from Kentucky.
Kentucky, Tennessee, and Indiana.
Well, in case you didn't know, this is Tennessee.
I like Tennessee.
So, I know. So once you start traveling and you just don't, you don't even know what's going on. But, hey, did you know that today, Ma Bell, is National Creamfield Donut Day?
Yum.
I got to encourage myself today. And, you know, a lot of times you're not supposed to have comfort food, but I have some chocolate cream-filled donuts right here. Right? Would you like to share one while I'm singing? I got to take a bite before
Absolutely.
I sing. Okay, so you have...
I have to eat little bites.
With the cream filled right inside. No. And yesterday was National Peanut Day, so I got peanuts for the day. I shouldn't have done that. I could not sing after I ate peanuts. They choked me up. But, boy, that's better than
I thought.
Isn't that good?
I have to eat little bites.
Yeah, little bites. You have to have little bites. And I have to have my little drink here out of the AM Kevin Club mug, which every beverage tastes better in an AM Kevin Club mug. I have, I did not get a picture of you drinking because you do not have your AM Kevin Club mug, Ma Bell, but I'll make sure I get one next time you show up.
Okay, it's all a right. deal.
Is it okay? Can I sing a song to you?
Absolutely.
This is on my new, where's my new? My new CD, Grown Up Gospel, ladies and gentlemen, and my niece sings with me on this song. So I hope you enjoy it. I need this one. I feel this courage today. Kathy was such a great, sweet sister in our church. Why should I feel discouraged? Why should the shadows come?
eye is even on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. You say with me, I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. Let not your heart be troubled. I need that. His tender words I hear, and resting on his goodness, that's when I lose all my doubts and all my fears. And oh, the path he leads, but one step I may see, I know his eye is still on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. Oh, his eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. Come on, everybody. I sing because I'm happy. Oh, I sing because I'm
my doctor's calling me to remind me of my appointment. I had to have the big ending. I thought maybe I pushed a button, but it was my doctor. The fun things happen live. Good morning, Pastor Beatty. Good morning, Steve is in the house. Steve, Bernie, Cindy is in the house. California, Tennessee, Northern Ireland, Elizabeth is in the house. Darris in Texas, Larry, of course, Larry, and Gary. There's Larry and Gary, and we need a Mary now, right? Don't we? Or a Harry, right? We have something like that. Did you say something, Miss Ma?
Hi, Larry. Hi, everybody. Yes. And yes, we need a Mary.
We need a Mary or a Harry. Yes. Good morning out there in Kansas City or Overland Park. And Gary loves his eyes on the sparrow. And we froze again. But I know he watches me. And if you like this CD, you can get this CD at kevinchory.com. Call us at 844-47-KEVIN or write us at P.O. Box 222 Pleasant View, Tennessee 37146. Looks like I'm going to have to upload this again. But we'll have the whole show for you so you can get that. Help us today. Hey, you know, if you love your pets, here we go. We got pet health in a can. All you do is sprinkle a little bit of this powder all over your cat or dog food. It has a little beef flavor thing to it. But it helps in their bones and in their antioxidants, just helps them and keeps them healthy. I love this. I think I've added another year or two to Rocky's life. He's 15 going on 16, almost 16. Wow. I know. You know, he's got a new pep in his step. And I think it's because of this wonderful pet health. Go to my website. You can find the picture, punch on it, and you can go to it. Plethora of items. We got some new items since you were here, huh?
I see that. All kinds of neat stuff there.
I know neat stuff. I want you to sing your platinum hit song in just a bit, but I'm going to go to the place where they like when I do this one. It's called my soapbox. I mean, you get to watch the show. What do you think about the soapbox?
Is it I love the soapbox.
You know, I just love it. It's probably therapy more for me than anything, just getting up on the soapbox. But also, I think I share some things you can think about, like Larry says, right? Where is Larry? Larry! Take it out, Larry! Or take us over there.
It's time now for Kevin's Soapbox. News, thoughts, and commentary from your host, Kevin Shorey. Now, here's Kevin.
Today is September the 14th, 2021, but it's September the 14th in 1814. A man by the name of Francis Scott Key. Oh, can you put me up a little bit? I cut my head off. I don't even know why. Ruthie's in the house and helping me. Thank you, Miss Ruthie. Oh, and she even centered it. She's the best. You're hired. Francis Scott Key, you heard of him? He wrote the lyrics for, with no racism involved, by the way, to the Star-Spangled Banner, which became our national anthem during the War of 1812. Francis Scott Key. I'm not sure, but it just struck me a little funny. Just posing the question, not throwing anything out there, not casting disparagement, judgment, or criticism. But after the first football game, which was Cowboys, Buccaneers, and Buccaneers barely slid by. Anyway, after watching the two different national anthems, the national African-American anthem and our national country, our country, Francis Scott Key, National Star-Spangled Banner, at the ball games, and then over the weekend they kept doing that. Does that bring us together? Or does that seem like it divides us or separates us? Does it really make us come together? I don't know. Just posing the question. Just saying. That's my soapbox. Sticking to it. Just saying, Larry. Oh, Larry.
This concludes this edition of Kevin's Soapbox. Thought-provoking news, thoughts, and commentary from your host, Kevin Shorey. Kevin's Soapbox is a regular feature of the AM Kevin Show. We hope that you've enjoyed it.
Whew! Hope you enjoyed it. I don't know. It's kind of like, I think in... like in church, when they started dividing services with, you've got the older folks that like the hymns and some of the older choruses, and then you have those that like the newer choruses. Why can't you do a little bit of both in one service and bring people together? Why have two services? We're not going to be segregated in heaven. That's just a pet peeve of mine. And anyway, this is kind of, I don't know, this is a pet peeve. I don't know what to think. I just thought I'd see what the response was, but now that we're not live, I can't really. There's Ray's in the house, and I mean, we keep coming back eventually. I think they're just getting pieces, though. So I want them to get this whole thing, the whole song, because you've got this song. Tell us about how you found out, or why is it, and just to celebrate, I'm having a chocolate, cream-filled donut. I should not be eating that at all. It's so good, though. So this is your song, America's Too Young to Cry, or what's it called?
America, She's Crying.
That's a good title, though. America's Too Young to Cry?
Yeah, that might be a good follow-up song.
I don't know. But tell us about this song, where it came from, what it's all about, and I'm going to set you up. I got a poem I found in Larry Lundstrom's newsletter. Larry and Gloria Lundstrom are dear friends of mine from South Dakota, now live here in Tennessee. But it's called America to Your Knees. But tell us... tell us about this song and set us up, and I will set you up with this.
America, She's Crying. I actually started a long time ago and never finished it. And COVID hit last year, and so I'm like, I need to rewrite this thing. And sent it to Bob McGilpin. He's the co-writer on this song. And it actually ended up, I actually had to sit down and think about what did all these lyrics mean, because people were throwing at me, is this political? And I'm like, no, it's really about our country needs to turn back to God.
Yeah.
We need to bring God back in the country. It's about a lot of different things, but, you know, I really think that America is crying, and the more I think about it now, it's even changed from when I wrote it, because I think now as you watch our country under attack, I think it becomes really more serious.
Totally, totally. And this is a great, great song. Who wrote this song?
I wrote the lyrics, and Bob McGilpin co-wrote it with me.
Yeah, wonderful, wonderful. And now platinum on the charts,
platinum.
Which means there's been like a million listeners.
It's a lot.
That is amazing. Now, if you just get a million CDs on it.
That'd be awesome.
Yes, you'll be too rich to ever come by here.
No, never.
Or you'll just take your jet here, your helicopter, and land.
I might just move here part-time.
That'd be great. That'd be great. I'll read this poem afterwards. Let's do the song first. Ladies and gentlemen, here is America, She's Crying.
What's happened to America? She used to be so strong. The things she now is seeing, they are so very wrong. Her people need to stand together and put up a fight. Her morals and her constitution have been compromised. America's seeing many things she thought she'd never see. Now she is a wondering who will her next leader be. Will they be corrupt or will they keep our country free? Only time will tell, we'll just have to wait and see. America, she's crying.
She's crying.
Keep standing tall, let's give it all we got. America, she's crying.
She's crying.
Let's take our country back, 'cause we the people are the boss. It's time for us as a nation to finally say enough is enough. America, she's crying.
She's crying.
Has some backbone, stand together even when the times get tough. What will happen next? Can she survive the hard times as she faces many tests? It's time now as a nation, we take some time today. Believe in God we trust as we bow our heads and pray. America, she's crying.
She's crying.
Keep standing tall, let's give it all we got. America, she's crying.
She's crying.
Let's take our country back, 'cause we the people are the boss. It's time for us as a nation to finally say enough is enough. America, she's crying.
She's crying.
Has some backbone, stand together even when the times get tough. Are we feeling it? It's only with God's help we can turn this around. If we follow him, he'll put us back on solid ground. God will one day show us we have nothing to fear. If we put our faith in him, he'll dry every tear. She's crying.
She's crying.
America, she's crying.
She's crying.
America, she's crying.
She's crying.
America, she's crying.
She's crying.
Stop your crying.
Yeah. Big hit, big hit. And America, she is crying. America, to your knees, your only hope is prayer. The world is filled with strife, confusion, and despair. But God is still in heaven. His power is over all. America, to your knees, in supplication call. America, to your knees. Night shadows lengthen fast. Soon judgment will descend, the day of mercy past. Our only hope is God, on him we must rely. America, to your knees, he will hear our cry. America, to your knees, your forefathers of old loved God and served him faithfully, for righteousness were bold. They read and lived God's word, honored the Sabbath day. America, to your knees, confess your sins, pray. America to your knees. Now is no time for pride. In humble pleading, call on God that he be on your side. We've sinned and disobeyed. We've wandered far astray. America to your knees. Return to Christ today. Esther Rustoy wrote this, America to your knees. And it is so,
that's really
so
good.
True. What's that?
That's really good.
Yeah. And it's really relevant for now. And it's America, she's crying. And we need to pray for America. We need to pray for those who have sent in prayer requests and stuff. And so we're going to have prayers or something we can pray with you about, Miss Ma Bell.
Yeah, there's a friend of mine that wants to encourage today. His name is Thurman. And he was given bad news yesterday. And we want to definitely lift Thurman up.
Yeah, definitely. We lift up Thurman. Let's go to God in prayer. God, we lift up Thurman. We lift up our nation. We lift up those who are sick in body. We know that you're able to heal Melody, Suzanne, Thurman, Janine, and the whole family. Karen have now come down with the COVID, but we know you are the answer. God, you got me through. You've gotten many people through. Bring healing to them. Continue healing Lila Renee, that little baby. Casey and Linda, Ginger and her granddaughter Elizabeth, daughter Tammy. For Lana, Rick tells me that Lana's really been going through it lately, but we're praying every day for against Lana's COPD, I believe it was her CPOD, whatever it is, but a breathing issue in her lungs, God, that you're going to be with April and Jeff, Sandy today. Let her heal quicker. They said she's healing slower, but God, speed up the recovery in her shoulder. Be with Sandra in this new season of her life. May she sell her house, but bring healing to her body as well. For John, Madeline, Leon, Lynn and Josh, Carol, Hazel and Tammy. For Morris, Adam, God, also with COVID. But you're able, God, to bring healing. Norma and Jim, Gary's daughter is still in the hospital. Raise her up right now. Strengthen her. Draw her closer to yourself. Be with my friends, the Portwoods, as they're recovering from COVID, God. And just as this nation is just in such need of a revival, such need of coming back to you, God. So I lift up this nation. I lift up all families involved with all these different disasters, from the floods here nearby, Waverly, New Orleans, for those in Haiti from the earthquake, in Afghanistan that need to get out. God, all over the world, you're able. We pray for the peace of Jerusalem in the Middle East, but a mighty revival for this nation. Be with our pastors and ministers and leaders of this nation. God, I thank you that you not only hear our prayers, but I know you go to work to meet every need. We declare that we are strong in the Lord and the power of his might today, and we put our proclamations before you again, that we put on the whole armor of God so we can stand our ground, so that we can declare the power we have over the schemes and strategies against the evil one. We know it's our destiny to win, and every battle that you allow, God, you intend for us to win. So we not only put on the helmet of salvation, we put on the breastplate of righteousness, knowing we're forgiven through Christ. We put on the belt of truth. And thank you, as we turn from any sin, that we declare complete forgiveness and acceptance from God through the blood of Jesus today. We put the shoes of readiness on our feet, so we're available to go where you want us to go and do what you prompt us to do. Tie our hands to your purpose. Bind our feet to your path. We take up the shield of faith and reject every lie and temptation of the devil. We raise up the sword of the Spirit, knowing it is the Word of God. This sword we wield, God, we recognize it's a basis for what we believe and what will come out of our mouth today, and we wield it against the enemy. And we yield to the Holy Spirit. Come into our life and fill us with your presence. Help us to bear much fruit today and every day. We give you praise. Thank you that you hear these prayer requests. You hear these needs, God. And for those that have these needs, we're not able to be totally live right now. But God, when they see this, may they offer up and join with us. Where two or more agree touching any one thing, we know it shall be done. And we give you praise in advance, for the answer is on the way. And we give you praise, God, in Jesus' mighty and matchless name. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. You're a good God. Every good and perfect gift comes from him. He's a good God. Isn't he a good God?
He is a good God.
He makes cream-filled donuts, and he is a good God. Just one more, I promise, one more.
That's really good.
Whoops, I ate the whole thing.
Uh-oh. You're going to have another one.
No! You have the other one, so you it's yours. It's my gift for you coming today.
I'm going to eat it.
And speaking of gifts, my gift to everybody this month is our new AM Kevin Club Meg refrigerator magnet. It's the official of the AM Kevin Club, so you remember to pray for us every day. Because if you put it on your refrigerator, you know you're at your refrigerator every day. So there's the place to put it. So it's a refrigerator, the brand new refrigerator magnets. And every day is a celebration. Did you know it's also International Crab Fest Day?
Never had crab.
And you told me that. You've never had crab. Crab legs? Nothing.
Never.
Mm-mm. Crab salad or any?
I have had crab ragoon.
What?
Crab ragoon at the Chinese.
They put those ragoon. Yeah, it has like minimal amounts of, yeah. But that's close enough.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I love crab ragoons.
I like those too.
Oh, it's real good with the cream cheese inside the little wonton. Mm-hmm.
You're making me hungry.
I know. I shouldn't, but it's a lot of special days today, a lot of things besides that, besides the crab days and all that other stuff. Today in 1975, for the first time, you could hear this.
Gunsmoke.
You know what this is?
Gunsmoke.
Nope.
No. It's a Western.
Nope. 1975. Gunsmoke was like in the 50s, I think it started or 60s. 1975.
I remember it.
I know. If we were live, people would be typing in. And we've had a couple of members of that TV show on this show.
Really?
The Waltons. We had Mom Walton. We had Elizabeth. Not Elizabeth. The other one. Not Elizabeth.
Mary Ellen.
Not Mary Ellen. There's one more. What was her name? Elizabeth was the, right? No, it was Elizabeth, because Mary Ellen and, what was the little tiny baby one? That was Elizabeth. It was in between Elizabeth and Mary Ellen. Oh, I wish they were live so they could help answer. And look how it froze. Well, look at that picture of me. I look disgusted.
I see it.
That's terrible. That reminds me of that commercial with the one where they don't freeze, because, yeah, she has that face. Anyway. Yeah, that started in 1975.
Wow.
The Waltons. But who was that? It was, I didn't have Mary Ellen. I didn't have Elizabeth. I had the one that's in between. There's another girl.
I don't remember her name.
Do you guys not remember? Wow, what was her name? Has it been that long that we can't? Good night, Mary Ellen. Good night, Elizabeth. See, that's how I remember it.
Good night, John Boy.
And... yeah, I know, but...
and Mama and Papa.
Mama and... I can't remember. Stop it.
Thank you for being a friend.
Oh, well, I might as well say in 1985, this premiered today, September the 14th.
That's remember this song? Taking us back. Yes, thank you for being a friend.
That's the name of the song. What was the name of the show?
Oh, you're going to make me think.
Ma! I don't know. Are you Ma Bell or are you Kathy? I don't even know which one to read.
I'm Ma.
Okay, Ma.
The Golden Girls.
That's it. The Golden Girls. Ding, 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 ding. Thank you for being a friend. That's all I can play or else I get charged. Okay. It's going to bug me all day. Erin. Her name was Erin.
Erin. Yes.
Thank you, Jesus, for a good brain. It was the cream-filled donut that did it. And then I'm going to play the theme song tomorrow, because tomorrow another show premiered on the 15th of September. But today is the star of that guy's of that show, Clayton Moore. His birthday is today. Clayton Moore was a star of... he starred with Jay Silverheels.
I need more donut.
Hi-ho, Silver, away!
Lone Ranger.
That's right, the Lone Ranger.
With Tonto.
Right, Tonto was played by Jay Silverheels. Well, Clayton Moore was, it was on the radio before, but we'll do a tribute to the show Lone Ranger, but today is Clayton Moore's, was his birthday. Now, Walter Koenig, now I don't expect you to know who Walter Koenig is, but he's 85 today, he's still with us, but he played a character by the name of Chekhov on Star Trek.
We like Star Trek.
That's right, he was Chekhov. And he's 85 today, so happy birthday to all those birthdays and the birthday of the Waltons and the Golden Girls. And in 1716, way before our time,
way before.
The first lighthouse was built in Boston Harbor on Brewster Island, or as we say, Boston Harbor, Brewster Island. The first lighthouse. There's a lighthouse on the hillside. That's a great song.
That's a great song.
Isn't that a great song? Do you sing that song?
I will the next time, I promise.
Really? Have you ever sung it publicly before?
I have sang that song many times.
Okay, well then we'll definitely do that. We'll have to do that. And are you available? You're traveling and stuff if people want you to come to their church and do your rap or your...
Whatever they want me to do.
There you go.
As long as it's clean.
Yeah, well, of course. Of course. But you'll go to any church, birthday, bar mitzvahs, whatever.
Anywhere. I like to go.
I like that. How do they find you? Where do we find you? On Facebook is the best place, or
right
you have
now,
a website?
Facebook, really, under Maubelle Fish and Blues.
Maubelle's what?
Maubelle's Fish and Blues.
Fish and who?
Fish and Blues.
Blues. Oh.
Fish and Blues.
Fish and Blues. I couldn't understand. I thought you said bowls or balls. I didn't know what it was. I was hoping it wasn't balls. Anyway, it was Fish and Blues.
Yeah.
The Fish and Blues. You
know,
my...
They'll know her because of the hat.
Yes. Okay. I was going to say, I don't know what, because I'd lost totally any kind of idea of Facebook or whatever, so I'm going to stop the streaming part, but we're still recording, and so they'll get it, because we are recording. But the Fish and Blues, MaubelleFishandBlues.com?
It's just Facebook, Maubelle Fish and Blues.
Fish and Blues. Okay. I got to write this down because I'll forget. And I want to keep getting people there because then you can come to the... And you do comedy and you do parties and stuff? Like if they're having a something on the church, Christmas party, whatever.
We're adding more comedy and more songs and stuff. So
I love it.
Ready to go.
Where's your frog?
I forgot Jeremiah.
You cannot forget Jeremiah. I'm trying to write a song about Jeremiah.
Awesome.
Yes, we got to get a Jeremiah song, but a rap.
I'm ready for it.
I know. I promise the rap. I'm going to try my best to get the rap. Now, you have a couple songs and some stories about in between all this, and these are some mountain songs.
Yes.
But are you a mountain girl? Would you say you're more a hillbilly?
I think it's part, I'm part hillbilly from my dad's side.
Yeah.
And the other part's just, I don't even know what she is. I enjoy the scenery and it can get me in trouble real quick.
Yeah. Were you born, raised Kentucky then?
I was born in Indiana, but my dad's family's in Kentucky.
So it must have been southern Indiana, though.
No.
Where were you from then? How can you be so?
I'm north of Indianapolis.
Really? So you were a city girl.
Yeah.
In a way.
In a way.
But you were born there, but where were you raised there, too? Or you
yes.
Were just Indiana? Well, you're just blowing all my theories about your country nephidness, you know. But, you know, I was thinking the other day, this is kind of a Devo today. You know, Romans tells us, so Romans 8:28, all things work together for good. And maybe you can give, you got a joke. You know what? We should do, hold on, we got to do this first. We definitely got, I'm just all combobulated or whatever the word is from whenever we don't get live and I can't talk to all the people, but, you know, we got to do this.
Well, it's time for Kevin's joke of the day.
But we got to do your joke, okay?
Okay.
You got a couple jokes you can share with us in case one bombs and you can do the other.
Sure can.
Of course, nobody can tell us whether it bombs or not, but they'll tell us later. I'm sure they'll tell us later. No doubt.
No doubt.
Okay, I'm getting ready for the laughter. You ready?
I'm ready.
Tell me a joke.
Where does a fish keep his money?
Where does a fish keep his money? I don't know.
Drum roll. In the riverbank.
No, that doesn't get a laugh.
Okay.
You got a better one?
A better one.
It gets a little, but, all right, give me a better one.
Since we're going to the mountains.
Yes.
What do you call a bear with no teeth?
A bear with no teeth?
No teeth.
I have no idea.
At all.
No idea.
A gummy bear.
Now that's good. A gummy bear. That's really good. I wish I had gummy bears here to eat in celebration of it. But, you know, a lot of the word coincidence is thrown around a lot, but all things, you know, work together for good. God sees everything and puts everything together. And I was just thinking about sharing how, just to be being here, how there's no accident. First of all, that I met my wife at the church. My brother was pastoring, which had been the former theater of her dad's. It was a Mel Tillis Theater before it became Mel Tillis Assembly of God. That's a joke. It wasn't Mel Tillis Assembly of God. But anyway, so and then it became a church. And then I met Cindy there, and we got married, and we were married there in the theater. You know, that's not a coincidence. And then the fact that Mel had a farm here for 30, 40 years right here in Ashland City and moved to Ashland City, and no coincidence, there happens to be a stage up here in this wonderful Stonebridge Books and Gifts, 116 North Main Street, Ashland City, Tennessee, by the way. Right, that there's a stage here that we do our TV show here. I mean, all those things God sets up, and then we can be at peace. I remember, you know, peace was hard to come by in my life, like today with the whole thing. But now I don't get really rattled, you know, just so much. But, you know, I'm sitting on an airplane next to a lady that was just at peace, and she was happy, and I just wanted to punch somebody. I mean, I would never do that. But, you know, you just, sometimes life just, you know, and it was hot. The plane, the air wasn't working. And so I'm flying to go do a meet. I'm going to go preach. And here I want to slap somebody. Spirit of slap was on me. And this lady just was calm. And she started telling me her testimony, how she was in a car accident. And she was hit head on by a drunk driver and flew through the windshield and was paralyzed, quadriplegic, and said she could never walk again. But she said, I met Jesus in the field. I had never heard of Jesus before. Gave her life to Jesus, and Jesus said everything was going to be all right. So she just kept trusting him. And here I'm upset because I'm hot and I'm in a squeezing in the seat with fat people. Anyway, and so, you know, and then she ministers to me.
Wow.
No coincidence that she was there. Said God not only healed her, it's a miracle that she's no longer quadriplegic, but she was a little large. And I said, I know, it was a little. And she said, they said I'd never have any children, but we're expecting our first baby boy.
Wow.
I mean, God healed her and touched her. And I just know that God's got everything under control. I don't know who that's for today, but God's got everything. And when you sing a song like Tell the Mountain, yeah. I'm like, don't let the mountain overrun. You tell that mountain according to what God said. If we have faith in him and we talk to him and commune with him and abide in him and his words abide in us, we can ask what we will and it shall be done. And we can speak to any mountain and tell that mountain, I don't know if it has anything to do with your song, but we can tell that mountain, be uprooted and cast into the sea.
That's actually very, very powerful. And I actually just learned this song, so be patient. But it's interesting that you're going there because it's really touched my heart. I've wept as I've tried to learn this song, and I feel like it's out for quite a few people out there. For some reason, God's dealt with my heart with this song, and I myself have been through a lot of mountains, some finer than others, but
right.
But this song is highly powerful, I feel.
Yeah, and it's for somebody that's watching right now. The enemy might try to knock us off, you know, but we're going back on. It won't be live, but it'll be on Facebook and YouTube, and then all the stations will take it. And this is for somebody. I mean, it's if you think wherever you are right now is the end all, then it will be. But if you think God is using this to take you to another place, you know, I got up one day and they said, you got to fill in, and I didn't feel good. And I was PTL singer. And sometimes we had to go and introduce guests at a seminar or a camp meeting at that night, or take up an offering at one of the, whatever. We had to do a lot of different other jobs. And this was one of those mornings, go to the cabin, there's a seminar, there's a guy that's speaking there I've never heard of before. His name was Lowell Lundstrom, and open up with a song and introduce him, and then, you know, you're free to go. And that day changed my life. It was there that I met Lowell, that he invited me to go on the road with him, and I went around the world with him for 5.5 years, and it launched my evangelistic ministry, which may never have happened. A year later, PTL crashed, and there was all kinds of stuff. I've been right in the midst of it, So there's no coincidences. Okay. And God's got everything under control. He's got it for you. I think there's a word for you. This is a word for you that are watching today. God's got this. So let's do some songs to back it up, and you can tell us the story of between all this, too. But this is called Tell the Mountain.
Tell the Mountain. In the covered hill of sorrow, looking up from the valley of fear, you can see doubt off in the distance. You're about to lose heart right here. Don't ever give in, don't ever give up. God is with you, you'll overcome. The mountain will tell you that you can't make it over. It will try to convince you that it's way too high. Though you feel defeated, know that God keeps his promise. So Kevin, you tell the mountain just how big your God is. Here we go, everybody. Just try to remember all the trials he's brought you through. And when his hand gave you strength in the journey, the very hour you needed it too. Don't get discouraged, 'cause time after time, God's never failed you. Go on and climb. The mountain will tell you, sing it, Kevin, that you can't make it over.
Right,
it will try to convince you that it's way too high. Though you feel defeated, know that God keeps his promise.
Yes, he does.
So you tell that mountain just how big your God is.
That's a truth. Come on. That's perfect for what I was saying. God knew.
He knew.
He knew.
I learned that in about a week. It's like, and I cried a lot of tears as I worked on that one, because I've gone through COVID. I've gone a lot through my life that I don't share a lot, but I've about met my maker so many times, and there's a reason that I'm still here.
That's right. No coincidence. And you're here today.
I'm here.
No coincidence. You got another mountain song.
Well, before we do that, let's kind of talk about those mountains, because
yeah,
I think that's what today is about. We all are facing mountains right now.
Right.
And this story here, I couldn't make something up this crazy. I just couldn't, Kevin.
Come on.
But this is a perfect example about how you can get somewhere that you know, only God can figure the answer out.
Yeah.
And I took two elderly women with walkers, and I took my friend with seizures, and we headed to the Smoky Mountains.
Okay, beautiful.
And, oh, it was beautiful. It was gorgeous until we start going down the mountain into Cherokee. The brakes decided to go out.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh, no.
And I pulled over at a creek, and our brakes were smoking, and they stunk. And we had no phone service. And so we let it cool off, and we went to back up the mountain. We never made it to the Cherokee place. And we get up to the mountain. We meet this nice, handsome little forest ranger. And anybody that knows me knows I'm a little determined.
Mm-hmm.
And so we had this company that supposed to come and tow us out of the mountains. But I called at 4, and at 7, they still weren't there. And they were going to take my mom and the other two ladies down and leave me in the mountains.
Really?
Yeah. And
that doesn't sound nice.
At 7:30, the company still wasn't there. So the forest ranger calls a a taxi driver, which was $300, by the way. And,
oh, goodness.
Because there was nothing open. Oh. That's another lesson. Everybody, if you go to the mountains, go on in the morning when you can get help. So anyway, the answer there is that I was going to be stubborn because I knew that somebody had to stay with a car. And had I stayed, they'd have never picked me up, and I would have spent the night in the mountains with the bears and the wild animals. But anyway, they convinced me they should go. Jeremiah wasn't with me that trip.
Well, the frogs were there, I'm sure, somewhere.
Yeah, so anyway, that's my story about the Smoky Mountains. And as I thought about everything that happened to us, I also thought about all the mountains in our lives and how things are kind of rough right now. And the whole mountain thing, I think, is just kind of, I think even though things are rough, that there's positive things, too.
Yes.
And I think, like, for instance, we didn't get left in the mountains, and we were safe. We could maybe not have been safe. They didn't know where our car was for 24 hours. They couldn't track it.
Oh.
So, but we ended up spending another two nights and enjoying the Smoky Mountains. So, and everybody was okay, and I think that's the main thing. God's got this when we're in our rough times.
Yeah,
we just got to take things to him.
No, good word for today, you know, and I love that Tell the Mountain song. You could do that one every time you come by here. But I've not heard this one. I can't wait to hear Don't Let Smoky Mountain Smoke.
Get in your eyes.
Okay.
I picked this one because it's a pick-me-up from that story. And you'll see the humor in it. And Kevin, it's a catchy little tune.
Come on, let's do it then. I love banjo. Mandolin.
Don't let the Smoky Mountain smoke get in your eyes. If you do, I'm telling you, you'll want to live there for the rest of your life. If Smoky Mountain smoke gets in your eyes, if you're looking for a place that you will love, Smoky Mountains, Cherokee, the closest place to heaven that I know of, Smoky Mountains, Tennessee.
Come on.
So Kevin, don't let the Smoky Mountain smoke get in your eyes. If you do, I'm telling you.
Tell me.
You'll want to live there for the rest of your life if Smoky Mountain smoke gets in your eyes.
You know what, my solo.
Quiet, Kevin.
Air banjo.
Smoky Mountain paradise. You'll want to live there for the rest of your life if Smoky Mountain smoke gets in your eyes. Don't let the Smoky Mountain smoke get in your eyes. If you do, I'm telling you, you'll want to live there for the rest of your life if Smoky Mountain smoke gets in your eyes. If Smoky Mountain smoke gets in your eyes. I thought I was gonna live there.
Yeah. Whoa. I like that song.
I found it.
You found it. And you gotta do the Tennessee theme song. We're gonna go out with the theme song. Everybody, even though the volunteers did very horrible on Saturday.
And you're gonna sing it with me, right?
I will do my best. It's like I sang that one. How did I do on that song?
You did great. I like to harmonize with you.
Nice. Okay. We're going to go. Remember, Jesus is the answer for this world today. We'll be back tomorrow on Friday. Tennessee River Boys will be right here in this place, and it's going to be a great time. But this is a great week. It's been a great week, and thank you, Ma Bell, for being here.
I love being here.
And you brought us a great word today. Just tell your mountain, be uprooted, cast into the sea. Don't let that mountain, that situation overwhelm you. Remember, there's no coincidence. God is using that to make you stronger. So let's get stronger. And let's sing it from good old Rocky Top. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, I wish I was. Here we go. We're going out, not with our closing theme. We're going out with Rocky Top. Woo! Play it, boys. It'll show up somehow. Here we go.
Telephone bills. Once I had a boy on Rocky Top, half bear, the other half cat, meow. Wild as a mink, but sweet as soda pop, I still dream about that. Oh, Rocky Top, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee. Once two strangers climbed old Rocky Top, looking for that moonshine still. Uh-oh. Strangers, they come down from Rocky Top, I reckon they never will. Corn won't grow at all on Rocky Top, dirt's too rocky by far. That's why all the folks on Rocky Top get their corn from a jar. Tennessee. I'd normally dance here.
Well, go ahead. She'll get you.
I might fall down.
Kick up your heels.
The red and the white socks.